Morena Wairarapa. Here's MMP for another week. Move, mingle, and play. Ko Rob Maunsell. I'm with you for the next 50 minutes or so. And joy over joy, we have Colette with us today. Good morning, Colette.
Morena. Hello, good morning.
And I think you're on. You won't get on film just yet, but
okay, that's all right.
But here it comes. There we are.
So, oh dear.
Colette, hello. Everybody. And Colette's going to talk about live music, performance, songwriting, what's happening out there, what it's like to try and be a professional musician in the current environment.
Yeah, a bit of that. It's been an interesting year, that's for sure. Yeah.
Yeah.
And we were just talking about a news article that we saw in the Dominion this morning.
Yesterday.
Yeah. I saw it for the first time this morning. Where it's saying that music is in dire straits and that job losses are looming. So that's quite scary. And that's probably looking at the big corporates in a lot of ways, you know, who are putting on the big shows and things like that. Arena style shows, and they're looking at has it been proposed that they're going to get luxury
isolation accommodation
for bringing in some international rock artists. I don't know if it's just rock, but
I think there needs to be a carrot.
International music. But also I think that the carrot is New Zealand in a lot of ways because people are pretty damn sick of COVID now.
Yeah.
And especially my friends that I have overseas in the UK and in America, they're just so fed up. And I was watching on the news this morning that they said in the States yesterday there was somebody dying from COVID every 30 seconds.
Really?
And it was something like up to 3,000. I don't know if that... They didn't say if it was in the space of 24 hours, but, I mean, it's not getting better over there.
We don't get the fear and the uncertainty and the devastation that goes with that, do we? And these are not
so
just
isolated.
Old people or sick people.
No.
These are quite well people who are getting bold. Well, so it's way worse than an average flu.
Two of my very good friends who they're Kiwis, and they live in Carterton, actually, but they were over in Portland, Oregon, which is where I'm actually originally from, and they were there for a year, and both got COVID, and were very, very, very sick.
Really?
This is back in April or March or April, and at that stage, there wasn't the infrastructure to even know how to deal with that, and they were just told to stay at home.
Yeah.
And both of them thought that they were going to die, didn't tell the other person.
Yes. Were they living on their own?
They were living just on their own in their own apartment in the city.
Yeah. And people came and helped out, or they were told to stay away?
No, they were told to just isolate and stay alone.
Excuse me.
Yeah. But she ended up going back into hospital because she ended up with some gastric issues as a result of COVID. Yeah. And I think that that's the thing that we don't really think about is how long-term some of the side effects can be. And that it's actually, for my friends, almost a year later, like 10 months later, and they're still both suffering the repercussions of it, like respiratory and gastric.
Well,
so it's quite scary.
Post-viral syndrome is very well recognized, and I think that's the next story to come out of COVID.
Yeah.
I mean, it's often called chronic fatigue, fibromyalgia, and then there are certain depression states and certainly a great deal of anxiety that can be a consequence of having had an illness like that for someone who's never been ill before.
Yeah, and you might find that there's even PTSD
for
those people who've had, to live through it and had loved ones die and that kind of thing. I mean, it's just earth-shattering. Yeah. We've segued a little bit, but we're talking about music. But it is all interrelated, very much so. Mm. And, I mean, for me, I actually took a year off from my day job this year to do music.
Mm.
And, of course, all of my gigs were cancelled.
Yeah.
But I've been quite lucky in that I've been able to take the time to really, really push and drive to get gigs.
Yes.
And so I've been keeping busy for the last few months anyway.
Yes, you have.
And
you're not that pushy.
Oh, No, I'm not. But because I'm organizing my album launch tour in January, which is it's only a few weeks away. So the album is releasing on the 15th of January, and we're playing in opening in Taupo, which is sort of my hometown. I consider Taupo my hometown. Yeah. And you know the song well because you've actually performed it with me.
Yes.
And so it's called the Memory Lake Tour.
Yes.
And that's the name of the album.
And where are you playing in Taupo?
At the museum. Yeah, so that tends to be where it's the best venue really to perform in Taupo at the moment.
Yeah.
And I think it has been for a few years. I've seen a few gigs there that have been
What date is that?
That's on the 15th of January.
Yeah.
Yeah, right. And then the next day we're going up to Auckland and we're playing at the Wine Cellar on K Road, which is a cool kind of indie venue.
Yes, that's very nice.
And then so it's going to be tight. So we're going Taupo, Auckland, and then the next day we're playing in Hamilton.
Yeah. So we should get a bus to go up to the Taupo show.
Yeah.
We probably won't follow you all the way up to Auckland and then Hamilton. And what's after Hamilton?
And then after Hamilton, going to the Kauranga Hall, which is in Thames. And it's this cool, you go up the Kauranga Valley, which is just outside of Thames.
Mm.
And it's a lovely little old hall, traditional kind of. Yeah. But I've seen a few bands play there. I saw the Eastern play there when I was living in Thames. And it's a really neat venue, just beautiful mountains and bush around you and stuff. So, yeah, playing there on the 19th.
That's the weekend.
That's the Tuesday, actually.
Oh, it's the Tuesday. So the 17th is the Sunday.
Yeah, so it goes 15th, 16th, 17th. So that's Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
Yeah.
Then I'm giving myself a day off. And then have a gig in Kauranga. And then I'm hoping to set up a few gigs going through Coromandel.
Yeah.
And maybe over to the other side of the Coromandel Peninsula. Yeah.
Fitianga.
Cook's hopefully.
Cook's Beach.
So
Hot Water Beach.
I'm hoping for Coromandel Town.
Oh, Coromandel.
And then there's a place called Kuatunu, which is just north of Fitianga, and then maybe one in Fitianga.
Mm.
So there's three kind of possibilities. And then playing the Paisley Lounge.
Napier.
The Paisley Stage, I think.
Yeah. That's in really
Napier.
Cool.
Yeah. And
that's got the controversial naked woman on the wall.
Oh, does it? Fantastic.
Yeah, lying. Kind of stretched out.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Yeah,
okay.
Kind of Baroque art style.
Cool.
Yeah.
Well,
and the women don't
there.
Mind, apparently. There was a great deal of concern
mind.
About it being sexist or something or other. And when the women were asked, they said, it's all right, fine.
So yeah, it's celebrating there. Us.
Exactly.
Yeah. Well, and then the final one's down in Wellington at Meow. You know Meow?
I do.
Yeah, so that's a cool
venue. So we're going to come and listen to you there too.
Yeah, that'd be fantastic.
So you're touring with your buddies?
For the big ones. Yeah. So for, how many is it? I think five of the gigs, they'll be with me.
Yeah.
And then the Kauranga Hall, I'll do solo. And then maybe through Coromandel, I'll go solo as well. And then, I've got some really cool acts that are supporting me, though, which I'm quite excited about. So there's in Taupo, there's an act that's... So they're all local to the area where I'm playing. And one, they're called False Heights. And they're sort of folk pop duo. And then up in Auckland, I've got this female songwriter. So her name's Isla, I-S-L-A. And she writes some really catchy. Again, it's poppy folk. A bit more poppy than me. I'm a little bit more alternative. Then in Hamilton, these guys I saw perform... they're these two young brothers who are teenagers, and their act is called Two of Three, and they are just the most phenomenal musicians I've ever seen. One's a flat picker on the guitar, and the other's a mandolin player, and they played at the folk festival when I was there. And they were part of playing with You, Me, Everybody, you know that? The act. Did you see? You would have seen them play. Yeah. You would have seen them and just been like, oh, "Those guys are great." So they're playing in Hamilton, which I'm quite excited about. And then at the Paisley stage, there's a band called the Spooky Skeletons.
Ah, that are kind of not the Skinny Millionaires.
No, Spooky Skeletons, which is a really cool, funny band name, and they're quite quirky, and they're Americana kind of.
Yeah, Hawke's Bay throws up some great bands.
Cool.
Yeah.
And then in Wellington, it's the Grolluxes are opening for me. Uh-huh. Do you know the Grolluxes?
Only through you.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, you've told me.
So, the Grolluxes are a band, and they've got affiliations with French for Rabbits as well, I think.
They were at the Folk Festival?
Yeah, they were. Yeah. They were at the Folk Festival too. Good. So. Yeah.
What a show.
I'm really excited for January. And then the next day, I go back to work because term at Rathkill starts on the Sunday.
Yeah, yeah.
So it'll be busy.
Teaching drama.
Yeah.
And English?
No, just drama.
Just drama. You're just a pure drama teacher, aren't you?
Yeah. I have taught English before. And
it goes with your performing. Yeah.
Well, when I'm teaching drama, I'm staying back behind.
Have you got some productions planned for next year?
So for next year, it's there's somebody else is going to direct the show. Her name is Laura Wood, who has been essentially me this year over at Rathkill.
Mm-hmm.
And she's staying on for at least half the year next year.
Mm.
And she's going to direct a musical, which I will not announce yet because it has not been announced. But there's a big show that they're going to do.
So she's a musician as well.
No, she's just purely drama. And Lucy Hepburn is the musical director.
Yeah.
And she'll have her hands full because it's all music, no script. It's one of those that's...
Yeah, everything. Bollywood.
But you still need the director to say, you are going here and this is your emotion and all of that kind of.
Yeah. Hey, I wonder if we could punctuate our conversation with a track from Jackie Bristow.
Absolutely. So
I just met her on Sunday. Jackie was playing with Barry Saunders at Cannon's Heath, which is Pippin Simon's house concert venue. And she was just amazing. So I'd like to play her acoustic version of Whistleblower.
Feel it go from blowing and I don't see the fog lifting. Nothing is black or white and there is gray in the light and everybody's got their poison. I wish I could get off this train. Thought I heard you call my name. It was just the wheels are turning. Ooh, ooh. Hear the whistle blowing. Ooh, ooh. Goodbye. Lifting. Ooh, ooh.
So we're back on, Colette. How was that?
I thought that was really cool. I was just saying, she reminds me a little bit of Gillian Welsh, but with a slightly, like Gillian Welsh is a little bit more gritty. But yeah, cool.
So how about we have some events that are coming up?
Let's talk about it, absolutely.
Because we've got a busy weekend. We've got the final Christmas parade in Masterton.
Yeah.
And then it goes to a Christmas Carols in the Park concert on Saturday.
When, so is that this weekend?
This weekend.
Oh, excellent. Okay.
Yeah. I thought so I'd get that in because it's probably
because
on your
list.
I
don't know if I've got it here or not, but I have got 3 pages worth of events and things. So we will go on from here, I guess.
December the 17th at the top of the page.
Oh, yeah. Okay. We'll go from here. Masterton Art Club is happening on Thursday. That's today. And that's from 10 a.m. till 2 p.m. And you can get tutored classes as well if you want. So tutored classes are available. That's on Victoria Street. You have Steady As You Go Falls Prevention Class with Age Concern at the Senior Citizens Hall. And that's at 9:30 a.m. Girl Guiding New Zealand, Carterton Pippins, 5 to 7 years old, and that's at 4:15 till 5:30. What else have we got? Whaka Ori Ori Shufflers, Line Dancing, Red Star Club Rooms in Herbert Street. That is at Masterton Intermediate, 1 till 2:30 p.m. On Friday, Aratoi Exhibitions, Angela Busby and Dennis Handyside, Out of the Woods to February 14th, Family Tree Whakapapa by the Slavic Sisters to February 14th, Terry Tito, Whakato Miro Miro to February 28th, Crystal Chain Gang and Flux and Sam Ducker Jones, Hi. To March 7th. Sorry, it is quite small and the lighting is dark in here. so that is happening at Aratoi, which is really cool. So there's lots of different exhibitions at the moment and worth a walk through, really, because that's all free with just koha, so definitely worth going in. You've got Tanui Craft Corner and Museum, Friday till Monday, 10 a.m. till 4 p.m., groups by arrangement. Masterton Variety Club, they've got a practice at 10 a.m. noon, and new members are welcome, so it looks like they're looking for new members. Carterton have a craft market, and that's 7 days, 10 a.m. till 2 p.m., and that's High Street North in Carterton. Cloth Corrected Sewing Workshop, Cloth Collective Sewing Workshop, 10 a.m. till 2 p.m. in Featherston Community Center. So there's a few different crafty things. There's a needlework and craft drop-in as well, 10 a.m. till noon, Featherston Community Center. So it looks like it's in the same place, but they've got two different events happening. Greytown Music and Movement for Preschoolers. So if you've got some little ones that are all around and you want to entertain the kids, there's a few here. We've got the Greytown Music and Movement for Preschoolers, 10 a.m. And this is tomorrow at 10 a.m. at St. Luke's Hall. Or you've got Kids Song and Story, which is fun songs, finger plays and stories for under fives during school terms, 9:30 till 10:30 a.m. at Epiphany Church Hall. So I guess that's not for right now because it's during school terms. Cobblestones Museum, that is opening. They have a resident printer who is recreating the activity of an old letterpress job printing shop in the early 1900s, which could be an interesting thing to do, is from 10 a.m. till 4 p.m. every day. The printing works thing is on Saturday and Sunday between 1 and 4 p.m., so that's something for the kids to do.
And he's really informative. He's a great teacher. He loves what he's doing, and he communicates it really clearly, and it's hands-on.
Yeah, I think anything that's like lost arts of the, you know, things like even... Well, I wouldn't call it arts, but steam trains and things. People who use the old machinery from, when it all first came out. When the machinery was first introduced, they're very passionate about it. And there's a lot of history.
We saw a clip of the steam train that goes up the Wecker Gorge.
Oh, wow.
In North Canterbury.
Yeah.
And there's a whole bunch of people. The oldest guy, I think, is 93, still... In the cab of the engine.
Yeah.
I don't know that he shovels much coal anymore, but he probably has his hand on the throttle.
with a minion grandson or granddaughter or something doing the coal.
Hey, just with the cobblestone.
Yeah.
They're also got a carols afternoon 4:30 on Saturday. Did you see that at the bottom?
Oh, no, because it continues half, it's not printed very well for them. Yeah, so that's a good one to note, actually, carols at Cobblestone, so Saturday at 4:30 p.m.
Yeah.
That would be really fun. Mm. I love Christmas carol events.
Yeah.
you've got quite a lot still on Saturday. There's some women's self-defense. Featherston Heritage Museum as well are doing a behind the Featherston Library. So I guess it's, they don't really say what they're doing. It's just open.
Yeah. I think everybody will be going to the Masterton Christmas Parade.
Yeah.
I think so.
I think on Saturday.
We almost don't need to put anything. But we should mention that in the Wairarapa College Hall on Saturday at 6 o'clock, there is a display of young talent from the Wairarapa.
What kind of a display?
Musicians. I won't say what sort of musicians, but there are two bands and Meg Hunter playing with Alex Hartley. The two bands are the Wycole band called Dragonfly and the Rathkeel band called Dixon's List.
Ooh.
And I think they're rock to hard rock to metal.
Really?
They're hardcore, these guys.
Okay.
I might be wrong, and I might be wishful thinking.
Does it say who's in it? Because I might...
Mm. Well, Meg Hunter and Alex Hartley, somewhere I might have information about who's in the other bands.
Okay.
But just go along. 6 o'clock on Saturday. It's a gold coin entry.
Cool, yeah.
So they're not really hard pushed for funds, these guys, yet. They're learning how to play before they have to go out and... Make it pay.
Some of these guys, these high school students, can just play rings around other. There's some amazing talent.
Mr. Death Wish. We've had Mr. Death Wish at the Tin Hut.
Oh, yeah.
Julian Eldred.
Oh, yeah.
And I think he's just leaving school this end of this year.
Okay.
And he's got albums out, records his own stuff. Got a really quirky sound, plays his guitar, finds these amazing chords, and they're kind of off, but then he puts a voice on it, and it kind of pulls it together. Very clever.
Interesting. Yeah, it makes it interesting. And I think when they aren't just doing just the basic, then you want to go back and listen again, you know, and that's the thing that definitely attracts attention. Is important in songwriting is to have extra little bits or songwriting or and or production.
Yes. So while we're on the music information, I should mention about the Rag Poets.
Yes.
My mates, the Rag Poets.
Written here.
Have you got it on there?
Well, I couldn't actually read what you've written where they're playing, but they're playing on Saturday, December the 19th, which is this Saturday.
They're playing at the Marquis Hotel in Carterton. Is it Saturday or is it Friday? It might be Friday. I've got to find my.
You wrote Saturday 19th.
I know. I think it could well be Friday. Tomorrow.
Okay.
But I'll check on that and I'll come right back to you. Earlier on, Colette and I were talking about Jackie Bristow.
Yeah.
And what a cool voice she's got, and she mentioned John Butler. And I've managed to get a YouTube clip of our friend John.
We were talking about different guitars, being music geeks, and which guitars we really liked. And then it just turned into Aussie guitarists.
Yeah.
And this guy is just phenomenal. Most people know who John Butler is, but yeah.
Let's get him on.
I can't wait.
Yo, good feather, y'all. One more time for Katie Tunstall. One more time for the Yonder Mountain String Band. Before we begin tonight, we'd like to acknowledge the traditional custodians of this land, to the Native American people whose land we're upon tonight. We'd like to pay our respects to their ancestors, past and present, and to each and every one of you, and all the old people, all the old people, all the old people down your line who have brought us here to this space and time. We stand on the shoulders of our ancestors, and it's because of them that we see each other tonight. Thank you so, so much for being here. We love you. Are you ready to do this? Let's do it.
There we are, Colette. How was that?
Yeah, excellent. So that's a song from his newest album.
Yeah.
That I think came out last year, or could even be the year before. I don't know.
It was either end of maybe the year before, and that was a live concert somewhere.
Yeah. He's just a really dexterous.
He's been around a long time. He's really put Australian music on the map. Him and people like Paul Kelly.
Though when he was talking just then, he sounded quite American. So I wonder if he's. What the deal is with that.
Could
just be a performance voice.
So anyway, just correction, folks, about the rag poets playing at the Marquis or the Marquis Hotel in the Marquis of Normandy, it is, Hotel in Carterton. It's tomorrow night, Friday, December the 17th. Now, have I got that right? Maybe it's the
Friday, 18th. December the 18th. 18th.
Yeah, at 7:30. And that's a free concert, Vic. Who's their drummer, lives in Carterton, which is why they're coming up to Carterton probably. And apparently they've managed to organise to get paid by the pub so they don't have to charge anybody to come in the door.
Yeah, well, that's good. That's what a lot of pubs do.
Yeah.
I played down at the Thistle Inn a few weeks ago.
Yeah.
And I think when it becomes part of, you know, a regular thing that they have, so say every Friday night they have live music, then people will come knowing that there's live music that night, and it becomes like a something that draws the people in, so it makes sense.
And some people do get put off when they get asked to pay. We had three groups who didn't come in on Friday at the Tin Hut because it was a $10 cover charge.
Oh, really?
If they'd stuck around and asked, they would have got in for $7 because they were a group of more than five.
$10 is not that much.
I think.
But also, that it's an age-old issue that nobody wants to pay for talented people performing.
Well, maybe.
However, you know, like if they're famous, they'll pay $150-$200 for a gig for a big artist. So, you know,
and maybe it's a choice you make to go and listen to that particular musician or that band.
Yeah, and it's
whereas if you turn up at a pub, you don't necessarily know who they are.
Yeah,
pub hasn't promoted it. Particularly.
However, you could end up discovering something that's really special that you then love, and that's how you discover music. Mm. And it goes back to that thing that we were talking about with the article in the Dominion Post and the issue in how the music industry is actually in trouble because they've had virtually a year of not being able to have any performances. So. In order to keep it going and to have live music anywhere, people have got to accept and, you know, help out and support.
And there needs to be just a slight change in attitude.
Yeah, I think
which
so.
Is these guys are worth supporting, even if they're kind of, you know, struggling a bit. But if you actually go and listen, most bands or artists who have got the balls to get up there and play are actually quite good. They've rehearsed, they've worked on it, they've got some interesting material, they've got something to say. They're not just getting up there playing pop songs.
And I mean, myself, you know, when I perform, I'm putting my heart and my soul into it when I'm performing, and so you are often, you know, especially in a pub environment where they're there to socialize as well. It's a real challenge because they're not always even paying attention to you. And you just have to keep going. Yeah. You know, so some of the, like the Tin Hut's a great one because people usually go there for the music. And they're sitting there and they're paying attention and supportive and that kind of thing.
Well, Jeremy's trained them, of course.
Yeah.
Yeah, our president.
Yeah. But I think people should expect to pay a cover charge if you go to a live music.
Yeah, sure.
Anywhere with live music, and and if you don't, then you're lucky.
Yeah,
you know
exactly. So how can we help people change their attitude towards, you know, offering a little bit of support for local music?
Well, I think that the onus is a little bit should be spread.
Yeah,
spread across the both the people who are running the establishments and those who are coming, because if I think if the burden of the money side of it is coming from a bit of both, then it becomes something that is able to be repeated.
Mm-hmm.
And there's some longevity with it. So say you have a $5 cover charge, but the owner of the establishment says, okay, but I will pay you this amount as a flat fee, and then you get blah, blah, blah on top
from
of that.
Yeah.
Then obviously on a night that has music, you're going to get more people in. And so they're going to be spending money at the establishment.
And you get a name for having live music, and people ask what's on next, when's it on, who's coming.
And the great thing about a town the size of Masterton is that everybody knows each other. Or a lot of people know each other, so word of mouth is still a thing. And if you have a good experience and, you know, people are looking for things to do, after, I think after lockdown as well, people are wanting to go out.
Hey, let's get back to our events.
To
this is what
the
you,
things that are on that you can go out and do.
This is what you can go out
yeah,
to.
Exactly.
So also tomorrow night, Friday, December the 18th, at Club Wairarapa, Chris Kirkland is playing. He's a local musician, performed throughout New Zealand, Australia and Europe. He's a guitar and vocals soloist, playing a wide range of popular music from throughout the decades. So if you want something to do in Masterton, you don't want to go to the Rag Poets, go to Chris at Club Wairarapa. I think it might be a little door charge. I'm not sure. It's not very expensive. They're very supportive. Club Wairarapa, there's often live music at least once a week.
Cool.
And they have special events as well.
Yeah, yeah.
And then something interesting coming up at King Street Artworks, which is actually today, 6 o'clock tonight, and then repeated on Wednesday, the 7th of April, is Clicky Happy, which is a free photography workshop for youth. And youth goes up to age 22, with a focus on well-being. The workshop's free, but you must register before going because space is limited. So registration will be at King Street Artworks, 16 Queen Street. Unfortunately, I don't have a phone number, but you can probably look that up. And you could turn up at King Street Artworks during the day today to book in for the 6 o'clock Click Happy Live. One or two more things about it. It's a genius bit about Mandy. Mandy Lynn is the person who's created this project, workshopping students on-camera skills and getting them to look at life through the lens. So Mandy weaves in self-compassion, body positivity, creative resilience, and emotional fluency teachings into her mahi. It's ninja mentoring that connects. The students are learning media skills and gaining communication tools, but it's the brush-off gold that really fills their knowledge kitties. The satisfaction of connecting with others, the grit of pushing through barriers, and the increasing self-worth that comes from working in the environment that Mandy creates. So if you can get there tonight, bit short notice, but it's probably been advertised elsewhere.
Yep.
Click Happy at King Street Artworks, starting at 6 o'clock tonight, Thursday the 17th of December.
Have you got some more there?
After you.
Oh, no, I've just I realized that we only really got up till Saturday, and then we played some John Butler. And,
is that right?
And we've got Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday to talk about, too.
Okay.
But you go for
it. I've got one more thing for Friday. That's tomorrow. And that's Star Safari at Stonehenge, 8:30 to 11. So this is looking at the stars just after sunset.
Mm-hmm.
And the sunsets up there are beautiful. So that's Stonehenge, Aotearoa, 5 Ahiarua Road in Carterton. And you just turn up there.
By the old house.
By the old haunted house. We'll say haunted, shall we?
It's beautiful. I love it's such a cool
it is amazing. It's
thing.
So unreal.
Just because it's sitting on top of the hill.
And your imagination just goes off down all sorts of alleyways.
I'd love to do a music video up there.
I'm sure you can. I'm sure you can. Although no one's been there for 30 years, so.
Oh, Wow. Apart from somebody owns it.
People at night who go exploring.
Oh, yeah.
So there's also a stargazing course at Stonehenge Aotearoa on Saturday. So this Friday and Saturday, 8:30 on Friday night and 2 o'clock on Saturday afternoon. And that repeats on the 16th of January, the stargazing course.
That would be really, really neat to do. I'd love to do that, actually. Doesn't
so you
say
finish,
how much
you, go, you go through Sunday.
Okay, so Sunday, Carol's in the car park at 7 p.m. St. James Union Church, which is 116 High Street, Masterton. And they're going to be doing Christmas carols and snacks in the halls afterwards as well. So everybody is welcome. That sounds like it'd be really fun. And caroling is often done outside, and you know, where the carolers would go around to the different houses. So I quite like that idea. Then on Monday, you have spontaneous dance in Featherston Community Centre. Call Pavla Miller on 0220-753867. That's in Featherston Community Centre at 6:30. Also, Featherston Music Club on the Monday. So this is Monday the 21st, 7 till 9. That is happening. So fair amount of music on Monday in different things happening in Featherston. Carterton Scottish Dance Club meet at 7:30 p.m. at Carterton School Hall on Holloway Street.
Cool.
No partner is required, so you can come solo.
Can I just pull you back to Sunday?
Absolutely.
Guess what's happening on Sunday and also in Carterton?
What?
Forest bathing in the Wairarapa.
Eh?
Forest bathing in the Wairarapa.
So you get in your
tubs? At the Fensham Reserve. I don't know if it's closed off, but it's going into the forest to bathe. That's at 10:30 on Sunday morning, the 20th of December. It's only a two-hour bathe, but Wairarapa Nature Immersion. So this is the organisation.
Yeah, so that's Fensham Park, did you say? The bush.
Fensham Park,
yeah.
Fensham Reserve.
Yeah.
So the Wairarapa Nature Immersion offers guided forest bathing walks in the Wairarapa region. The walks support people to connect their senses, eyesight, hearing, touch, taste and smell with what is naturally observed along the way for the purpose of experiencing a deep sense of relaxation.
That sounds like mindfulness meditation to me in the bush.
But your eyes are open
wonderful.
And you're in the bush. Yeah,
yeah, yeah, like you can do walking mindfulness
bathing.
Meditations and things. That's
bathing
really
in nature.
Yeah.
So anyway,
what
these
cool
guys.
Idea. I like that.
These
Love
guys
it.
Are doing it, and that's Sunday. There's another chance to go on a journey with them.
That's really neat.
Okay. Well, that's my immediate stuff.
Okay. So going back to so Monday, we've got Play Gym, St. James Church Hall, at 9:30 in the morning.
Yep.
Carterton Food Bank. Now that's an important one at this time of year. So down the lane between Carter's and the Clock Tower, at Haumanu House, that's between 10 and 11 a.m. Monday to Friday. So if you can, and you like when you're in the supermarket, pick up another couple of cans of baked beans or something and take it down there.
Definitely.
It's really, really important and special thing to do. Free Community Fit Club, 6 a.m. till 11 a.m. in the Carrington Park, Carterton. The Dance Shed on Belvedere Road in Carterton has beginners line dance classes between 6 and 7 p.m. And if you're intermediate, it's from 7:30 till 8:30, so a little bit later.
Mm-hmm.
Tuesday, December 22nd, which is my sister's birthday, we have the Book Lover's Corner, which is very apt because my sister is a total bookworm. And that is 3:30 till 4:30 p.m. and that's here on Arrow FM, and that is we've got a link on here which you can have a look at in the what this is Wired Up at Times Age, isn't it?
Yeah
I won't read the link. Masterton Toastmasters meet in the Salvation Army Hall at 210 High Street, Carterton, at 7:30 p.m.
on which day?
This is Tuesday.
Tuesday
the 22nd.
Yeah.
We also have a chair exercise with gentle chair exercises from 2 till 2:45 in Greytown at the St. John's Hall.
Mm-hmm.
Featherston Wahine Singers, so that is girls only, 7 till 8:30 p.m. Featherston Community Centre.
Yeah.
We've got the Clareville Badminton Club, main stadium at Clareville, 7:30 till 9 p.m. Wednesday, so this is the last day before we then meet again. In the dance shed, we have a rock and roll dance class. So they have the line dancing that goes from 6 till 7, and then the rock and roll dance class at 7:30 till 8:30. And you've got beginners and couples coaching or just social. It can be competitive as well. So it's like all of the above, rock and roll dance. That is some of the most fun dancing, in my opinion.
Mm-hmm.
We've got Rangatahi Te Rangatira Youth Group. Join us for sports, food, and leadership. Carterton Event Center, text R2R to 027-742-2264. And, and Wairarapa Singers, this is a... this is on
choir.
Wednesday, December 23rd. I've got some friends in this.
They're the pros of the choral choir world.
Phenomenal. Yeah. So there's choral singing with at least two performances each year based in Masterton. So this is a call out if you want to become part of the Wairarapa Singers. And you need to call Sean Mulcahy.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's how you pronounce his last name. 379-9316. So,
right.
Yeah, very busy week. There's a lot of things that we didn't read out, obviously, because it's just pages and pages worth. So it's always worth having a look through if you're bored and want something to do.
And this program is online. You can look at it again.
Yeah. So
download it. You can what do you do? You
click
either
on
get
link.
On the, from the website of Arrow FM.
Yeah,
you'll get the audio. And if you want the visuals, you go to Wairarapa TV, channel 41, and on demand will give you a chance to look at this show again, pick up all the useful information we've given you.
In addition to that, so the Arrow FM website is arrowfmoneword.co.nz.
Yeah.
And that's also where you can do the Book Lovers Corner thing on the Tuesday, December 22nd.
So, I think we might have to finish quite soon.
Yeah.
I'd just like to do two more things. Next week, Michael will be here because I'll be on my way to Christmas with my sister in Auckland.
Fantastic.
In a camper van.
Oh, my goodness. Cool.
Driven by Susan. Anyway, Michael will do next week, but he might not tell you about the Castle Point Fishing Club competition coming up on the 8th of January, Friday the 8th of January at Castle Point Beach. Jetty Road is the annual Castle Point Fishing Competition. $5 a day for boat launching, there's prize giving, spot prizes, huge amount of raffles.
I think it's quite a big deal.
The organizer is Alan Schofield or Kate Stewart. Alan's phone number is 06372-6899, and Kate Stewart is 06372-6930.
So which day is that?
That's on January the 8th, Friday.
Okay. Okay. So
and then a little bit further in January is the Wildflower Festival at the Yibo Art Studio, starting Friday the 29th of January and going right through till the 14th of February.
Mm.
So it's 2 weeks of art, some performances and lots of music right next door to the Tin Hut.
January is a big month for music.
It is. And that's near the Turinikau Racecourse, just by the entrance to the Turinikau Racecourse. So you can look on the Yibo website, which I'm going to try and find for you.
I think if you even just type Yibo into Google, Yibo, it'll come up.
It's an art studio. State Highway 2 in Greytown is the nearest town. That starts on Friday the 29th of January. And you'll find that Zelda is a wonderful host. Lots of enthusiasm, lots of ideas. So we're going to go out with...
Bang.
Darren Watson, preaching blues.
Oh, fantastic. Darren Watson, he's a local-ish.
this morning. The blues walking like a man. I was up this morning. The blues walking like a man. All the blues, give me your right hand. The blues fell, mama child, and it tore me all upside down. And the blues fell, mama's child, and it tore me all upside down. Travel on, DW, just can't turn you round. Never had them, hope you never will. Ah. With the blues is a low down aching heart disease. The blues is a low down aching heart. Like consumption, killing me by degrees. I can study rain, or dry my blues away. I can study rain. I'm gonna drive my blues away. Going to the still ray. Stay out there all day.
Here we are back again, Colette. Wasn't that great?
Oh, I love Darren
Raw
Watson.
Blues he's, from Darren, Preaching Blues, that
he's
number.
Just amazing.
Off his latest album, which is titled Getting Sober for the End of the World, which is track
a great
number one.
Title.
And he doesn't drink.
Oh, really?
He doesn't drink anymore.
That's funny.
But Getting Sober for the End of the World is quite a political statement.
Yeah, jeez. Yeah? Well, I met him at the Folk Festival, so he played at Welly Fest this year.
Yeah.
And I think we were just looking it up, but I've got no data on my phone at the moment, that I'm pretty sure he's touring with Barry Saunders at the moment, or has just done. I saw something on Facebook
the
other day.
Well, Barry and Jackie are certainly out there looking for gigs, and they are great. Anybody who wants to hire, top-line musicians doing their own thing, plus one... June Carter song, Ring of Fire, but they do it the June Carter way.
Oh, like
because
sort of
she
old
told
school.
Barry how it was meant to go, and then Johnny got hold of it and made it into a rock song, you see.
Yeah.
But it's not a rock song. Hey, we're done for the day, folks, and I hope you have a lovely weekend coming up. Lots on. Thanks, Colette, for coming in again.
Yep, pleasure.
And good luck when you start work, and we'll hope you can find the odd Thursday morning just to come in here a bit early and bring us up to date with things.
So long as I can make it work with work. I'm not 100% sure because they've got a different schedule that I'm not used to yet this year.
But you can promote what they're doing.
Oh, exactly.
So there's buy-in, you can be their marketing face.
Oh, no, they've got a new marketing person actually this year. But I think they might start, lessons might start early on a Thursday, so I'll just have to look at what my schedule is.
Okay. Hey, well, thanks for coming, and we've got to be out of here, and thanks to Michael for having us, and he'll
Coffee
do the
time.
Show next week. Goodbye for now.
Merry Christmas.